Did you write the part for Tom Cruise?
Yeah, I did. I went to he was a fan of Boogie Nights, and that was great, you know, because he called me up and he said I was going to London. I happened to be going to London to promote Boogie Nights, and I went and met him. And I got to go to the set, the Eyes Wide Shut set. And
what was that like?
It was amazing. I met Stanley Kubrick, which is like meeting, you know.
Stanley Kubrick.
You know, the king, yeah.
Hi, Paul. I'd like to know more about your encounter with Stanley Kubrick on the set of Eyes Wide Shut, because your last couple of films seem to be heavily influenced by Kubrick. Yeah.
Well, let me just say that I don't think there's anybody that hasn't been influenced by Stanley Kubrick. I mean, it's just like, I mean, I don't know. I can't speak for other directors, but it feels like, you know, what he did was kind of a, you know, a watermark for all of us, just to say, like, this is how you should sort of treat what you do, and this is how you should address it with a kind of attention, compassion. And I was lucky enough to meet him, and it was a great privilege, great honor, and everything else. And
you met Tom on the set of Eyes Wide Shut.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh man.
That's better than Little Nicky, a little bit. I went and met him, and then met Kubrick, and Jesus Nicole Kidman, Christ. And you know, it was I'll take that one with me.
Yeah. There's a story that I read somewhere that. After a couple of takes, you said something to Kubrick, and then something like, you only need to do three or something like that? Or
no, we talked about the size of his crew, because he had like six people.
Amazing.
And I said, like, God, that's you got a small crew. And he was like, well, how many do you use? You know, and it was like one of those moments where you really have to assess, like a fucking 100.
Yeah.
That's too many.
Yeah.
That's a very good point.
Yeah.
I don't think I've said this before. It's no big mystery, but it was like he was nice to me when he knew that I directed Boogie Nights, but he was much nicer to me when he knew that I wrote it. Like, it was like, there was a difference. There was a difference between being a kind of a person who directed something and somebody who wrote and directed something, which is pretty cool. That kind of stuck around. And yeah, I count myself pretty lucky to have been there.
So that was incredible.
Because I love trailers. I grew up loving trailers, loving the good ones, certainly. I'm an aficionado, I suppose. I collect them.
What do you think is the best trailer of all time? Let's go last 40 years.
Well, certainly the Shining trailer with the blood coming out of the elevator is probably one of
also the scariest 30-second commercial, I think. I was when I was probably 10 when that movie came out that summer.
Yeah.
So we were around the same age. Mm-hmm. And when that would come on, I would like change the channel. I was so scared.
Yeah.
Like, what is this? I never want to see this movie. Of course, I saw it immediately.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was, that's probably, yeah, I agree. That was a good one.